Good morning, dear brothers and sisters. I pray you're all having a blessed morning on this beautiful Tuesday. All glory and praise goes to the Father. We're here another day, you guys. I just wanted to quickly come on and say hi, and I'm going to be leaving here tomorrow. So I pray that you all have a blessed couple days. I'll obviously try and do a quick video while I'm out there, if I've got an opportunity, just to show you, you know, kind of where I'm staying, and you know, give you another reason to get outside of our homes and outside of this concrete jungle and remove ourselves from these systems. So we can go out and truly learn and appreciate our Father's handiwork. And I did those last two videos. I pray you got something out of them. Even if it's one little tiny thing, the purpose of them was to show us that our Father is perfect, you guys. And He never changes. And He is going to consistently show us what we're to expect and what the future is going to look like. And He does that with everything, whether it be through scripture or through another fellow brother or sister. So I pray that you're constantly studying, you're constantly searching for the truth, so that when the time comes, your relationship with our Father will be so strong that we will hear Him plain as day explaining to us what is going on. And if you think about our fallen brothers and sisters, Daniel, Ezekiel, Noah, Moses, they all had such great faith that they could hear the Father audibly, clear as day, in their temples. We can have that relationship with our Father. It is necessary for us to have that relationship with our Father, because when things start to happen and start progressing as they are, faster and faster, stronger and stronger, just like birth pains, we're going to be able to need to hear Him just like Daniel did, just like Ezekiel did, so that when we need to know what to do next, He will tell us. So I pray you're working on that right now as we speak. Again, I pray you got something out of the last videos, but I just wanted to show you our enemy and how he works. I review every video. I go over every single video because I want to make sure that the message that's coming out is through the Father and is not my own personal interpretation. And there has been a couple videos where I felt either forced or not confident or whatever the, you know, negative evil spirit that's trying to influence me to stop the message from going out. And if I feel like that's the case and the Father tells me, then I get rid of it. I don't post it. But as I was reviewing part two, I could hear the enemy telling me about how I said the word okay too many times. And I know it's ridiculous and I know it's petty, but praise the Father for telling me, if that's all the enemy's got on you, is the fact that you use the word okay too many times, you're in good shape, my boy. So I want to thank you, Father, for relieving me of that spirit of insecurity. Again, that voice that's whispering in your ear, look at you, you look like a fool. You said okay like 1,000 times. Look at you. I rebuke you, Satan. Get behind me. Because it doesn't matter, again, how that message comes across, as long as one of you, and I truly mean that, one of you got something from that, that was the purpose and why the Father put it on my spirit to get that message out. I was in prayer today, and the Father gave me another amazing example, and is the true reason why I want to give you this message today. He showed me back in Egypt. I saw in Egypt where Moses was trying to convince Pharaoh to let his God's people go, the Israelites. And because the Pharaoh was filled with pride and ego, he could not let that go. So therefore, our father, Moses being the messenger, put it through him to explain that you're going to have plagues. And so the great plagues of Egypt, if you think about all of them leading to the very last plague, what was the last plague, you guys? And that was the taking of the firstborn. Now, I don't want to concentrate on that part of it, but what did the father do, what did the father tell Moses to do and to share to his people for the Passover and to prepare so that when this angel came to come take the firstborn, what did the father tell Moses to do to make sure that that angel did not come into their dwellings? Now, I know this example that I'm about to give is a physical example, and there has already been a couple comments about how there are physical examples, obviously, of the Antichrist and the temple, but our Father not only works through the spiritual, but he works through the physical. He will work through anything that he has created so that he can get his message across to us, brothers and sisters. So I want you to know that. But I want you to look at the symbolism in what I'm about to say. So our Father told Moses to take the blood of a lamb, okay? Who's the lamb? The blood of the lamb. And take that blood and to mark it over the doorway, okay? So to put a mark over the doorway, so then when that angel came and went to that doorway, the angel saw the seal of the blood of the lamb above the doorway and knew not to enter into that dwelling, into that temple, to take the firstborn. So I just wanted to give you that example because the Father put it on me today, and it blew my mind because I never put that together. And I just found it quite amazing that our Father, before any of this came out in the first stories of the Old Testament, through Moses, the plagues of Egypt, sealed the dwellings above the doorway with the blood of the Lamb, Jesus, Yahushua HaMashiach, the seal of our living Father, the Holy Spirit. So I pray you're all having a great day. The Father is amazing. He's made it so that the weather is beautiful, so that I can go and spend some much needed time with my family away from all distraction. And I'm talking about this thing that I'm holding in my hand right now, talking about the concrete jungle. I'm talking about this beast system that constantly that robs us of our time so that we cannot further our relationship with our Father. I'm going to miss you guys. I pray that you continue to further your relationships. Stay in Scripture, brothers and sisters, daily. Like I said in the other video, little by little, if that's all the time that you have. But just put yourself, immerse yourself into it. Because we need to be growing that relationship daily so that when the time comes, we can hear that audible voice of our Father, just like Ezekiel, just like Daniel, just like Noah, just like Moses. So that when we are put in front of a situation that requires for us to make a decision, a spiritual decision, both you and I are going to hear that voice of our Father telling us exactly what to do. So again, I love you. Enjoy the next couple days. I will definitely try to make a video just to kind of show you the beauty and the handiwork of our Father. Father willing, I will do another one of these videos. I pray you're all blessed and protected, and I love you. Take care of yourselves. Bye.